जय राधे जय कृष्णा जय वृंदावा
जय कृष्णा जय वृंदावना
श्री गोविंदा गोपीनाथ मदन मोहन
श्री गोविंद गोपीनाथ मदन मोहन
श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरी गोवर्धन
श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरी गोवर्धन
कालिंदिया मोना जय जय महावा
कालिंदी जमुना जय जय महावाना
केशी घाट वंशी वट द्वादश कना
केशी घाट वंशी बट द्वादश काना
यहाँ सब लीला कोइलो श्री नंद नंद
जहाँ सब लीला कोइलो श्री नंद नंद
श्री नंद यशोदा जय जय गोपाल
श्री नंद यशोदा जय जय गोपाल
श्री राधे जय जय देनुवत सागा
श्री रामादि जय जय धेनुवत् सागना
जय वृष भानु जय कीर्तिदा सुंदरी
जय वृषभानु जय कीर्तिदा सुंदरी
जय पौर्णमासी जय अभिर नागरी
जय पौर्णमासी जय अभिर नागरी
जय जय गोपीश्वर वृंदावन माधव
जय जय गोपीश्वर वृंदावन माधव
जय जय कृष्ण सका बटु द्विजराजा
जय जय कृष्ण सका बटु द्विजराजा
जय राम घाट जय रोहिणी नंदन
जय राम घाट जय रोहिणी नंदन
जय जय वृंदावन वासियत
जय जय वृंदावन वासी जत जन
जय द्विजा पत्नी जय नाग कन्या
जय द्विजा पत्नी जय नाग कन्या गन
भक्ति तेरा पैलो गोविंद तारा
भक्ति ते जहारा पैलो गोविंद चरण
तेरा स मंगल जया जय राधा श्याम
स मंडल जया
जय जय रातलीला सर्व मनोरम जय जय रातलीला
सर्व मनोरम
जय जय ज्वल रस सर्व रस
जय ज्वल रस सर्व रस सार
परकिया भावे ब्रजे ते प्रचार
परकिया भावे जहा ब्रज ते प्रचार
ते जानव पाद पद्म कोरिया स्मरण
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 दीन कृष्ण दास कहे नाम संकीर्तन
कृष्ण दास को है नाम संकीर्तन
श्री जानव पाद पद्म कोरिया स्मरण
श्री जानव पाद पद्म कोरिया स्मरण
दीन कृष्ण दास को है नाम संकीर्तन
दीन कृष्ण दास को है नाम संकीर्तन
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे
हरे राम राम राम
हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
जय जय राधे जय जय श्याम
जय जय राधे जय जय श्याम
जय जय श्री वृंदावन धाम
जय जय श्री वृंदावन धाम
कृष्ण बलराम जय कृष्ण बलराम
कृष्ण बलराम जय कृष्ण बलराम
कृष्ण बलराम जय वृंदावन धाम
कृष्ण बलराम जय वृंदावन
गौर हरे बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल नित्याय गौर हरि बोल
हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल नित्याय गौर हरि बोल
कल्याण हरिनाम संकीर्तन की
जय
लीला प्रभुपाद की। ओम अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुःवन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपः कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकम्। वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरोः श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सह गणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सह गणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे। नमो महावदन्याय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरद्विषये नमः। वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्रीकृष्णचैतन्य प्रभुनित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैतगदाधर श्रीवासादिगौरभक्तवृन्द। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। Welcome all of you to the Nectar of Instruction, Shloka number 8. We are doing the second part of this verse today. Let us first recite the Shloka now.
Tannama Rupa Charita Adisu Kirtananu Smrityo Krameena Rasana Manasi Niyojya Tishthan Vraje Tadanu Ragi Jananu Gami Kalam Naye Dakhilamityu Padesha Saram.
The essence of all advice is that one should utilize one's full time, 24 hours a day, in nicely chanting and remembering the Lord's divine name, transcendental form, qualities and eternal pastimes, thereby gradually engaging one's tongue and mind. In this way, one should reside in Braja, Goloka Vrindavan Dham, and serve Krishna under the guidance of devotees. One should follow in the footsteps of the Lord's beloved devotees, who are deeply attached to his devotional service. So it's a very, very important verse. In fact, this verse talks about the transition from Vaidhi Sadhana Bhakti to Vaidhi Raganuga Bhakti. So both are called Sadhana Bhakti. In Sadhana there are two steps, Vaidhi and Raganuga. Vaidhi Sadhana Bhakti and Raganuga Sadhana Bhakti. So, in the previous class, I devoted a lot of time in explaining about the nature of how one goes from reverential admiration to spontaneous affection. So, I will just show you the slides. I will not explain them because we devoted time in this last time. So, our ISKCON Society is for training the mind to be always engaged in Krishna's business. I have to, Prabhupada says, we have to mold our day in such a way that always that we are at every moment we will not be able to forget Krishna. Like that we should, one should practice. ISKCON is meant for creating an atmosphere where people can take to chanting of Hare Krishna, Prabhupada says. Then once a person comes to Raganuga stage, then Bhava Prema, that's all explained in 8, 9, 10, 11 verses of Nectar of Instruction. So these things I will not explain. So we will proceed. So these are activities that Vaidhi Sadhana Bhakta has to do to gradually come to the higher advanced stages. All this we do on the order of Guru. Therefore it is called Vaidhi Sadhana Bhakti, isn't it? 16 rounds chanting and following 64 related principles of Rupa Goswami, studying and discussing Prabhupada books, developing Shastra Chakshu, singing Vaishnava songs, and requesting Krishna Seva, praying to the deities and
अनुकूल संकल्प प्रतिकूल से वर्जनम जैसे अब्सॉर्बिंग माइंड एंड सेंसेस इन डिवोशन सर्विस. सो दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट स्लाइड बिकॉज ऑल दिस एक्टिविटीज वी आर ऑलरेडी करंटली डूइंग नाउ इन ऑर्डर फॉर अस टू गो फ्रॉम वैदि साधना भक्ति. दिस इज द प्रिलिमिनरी स्टेज. वी शुड डू ऑल दिस थिंग्स. कीप ऑन डूइंग डे आफ्टर डे, मंथ आफ्टर मंथ, ईयर आफ्टर ईयर. अवर सेंसेस एंड माइंड विल बिकम प्यूरिफाइड एंड वी विल ग्रेजुअली गेट अब्सॉर्प्शन इन कृष्णा कॉन्शियसनेस. And then how Krishna consciousness is natural. We explained it like the walking of a child or a red hot coal covered by ashes or nails attracted to magnet. So we gave these examples. So we have already explained about this. In Vaidhi, there is only order of guru and scriptures. Whereas in Raganuga, without having any force, very spontaneously one is attracted to serving and loving Krishna. There is nobody behind pushing them. So therefore we devoted time in explaining that a lot last time. Kunti feels only reverential admiration. Devaki feels a combination of reverential admiration and spontaneous affection. And Yashoda feels only spontaneous affection. Complete raga, ragatmika, bhakti. So Yashoda's love for Krishna is oceanic. And there is not even a tinge of reverence for Krishna. She never treats Krishna like God. She treats him like a baby only. Whereas Kunti treats Krishna completely like God. Whereas Devaki simultaneously treats him as God and child. So then in the spiritual world we call it as Ragatmika Bhakti, perfect spontaneous devotion. In this world practitioners are called Raganuga Bhaktas. They take one Ragatmika Bhakta as a role model and then they follow in their footsteps and practice Raganuga Bhakti. So, what should a devotee do in this world? One should perform the regular sadhana which we showed you before. Along with that, one should cultivate a mood, a specific perfect devotee like Yashoda, Radharani or like Sridhama Madhumangal, Sridhama Sudhama Madhumangal and all like that. They should aspire for their mood if they are attracted to that particular type of service. And those who are perfected in spontaneous service, such devotees are eternal residents of Vrindavan. They naturally love Krishna in specific relationship. So, in the 15th chapter of Nectar of Devotion, Raganuga Sadhana Bhakti is explained here. The prerequisite is that one should have a very strong lobha or desire. Today I am going to speak more on that lobha topic. Strong desire to serve Lord Krishna in a specific relationship. I want to serve Krishna in the mood of a gopa or a gopi or a servant of Krishna or a friend of Krishna. So we cannot imitate this. This is a very advanced stage. First we have to undergo bhajana kriya and we have to get rid of anartha nivritti. Then when we come to the nishtha stage, beyond nishtha comes ruchi. In that stage of ruchi, we can talk about these things, spontaneous devotion and practice. Then after ruchi comes asakti, attachment, and then bhava and prema and all. So how can we obtain this desire? By hearing how eternal residents of Vrindavan spontaneously serve Krishna in various loving moods. We have to simply hear Bhagavatam, Krishna Katha, how the coward boys are dealing with Krishna, coward girls are dealing with Krishna. Keep hearing the verses of Bhagavatam along with Acharya's commentaries and gradually develop attraction. When does the eligibility manifest? A strong desire is the singular overwhelming desire in one's heart to please Krishna in a particular way. No other desire shares that desire. So until such lobha is not awakened yet, the material desires may still linger in our heart. Once that lobha has powerfully arisen, the material desires vanish. So therefore, here he clearly says, in following the regular principles of devotional service, there is a stage called anartha nivritti, which means disappearance of all material contamination. After that only one can expect this lobha to become stronger. Before that, the lobha is actually very thin and weak because it's mixed with material desires. At that stage, there is no need of any big, strict regulations for this devotee that you have to rise in the morning, you must complete 16 rounds. Spontaneously, a devotee does 10 tens and dozens of rounds he may do, and he is spontaneously attracted to seva. Nobody needs to supervise him. Therefore, he is beyond ordinary rules and regulations. Yeah. So, three practices for spontaneous devotion, Raganuga, Sadhana Bhakti. We discussed last time, remembering Krishna with a particular devotee. That I already told you in Vrindavan. Here, Krishna with Yashoda, Krishna with Radharani, Krishna with Balaram or Gopas. We may not be able to physically go to Vrindavan, but we can mentally meditate on those pastimes. So, again, as I told you, these are advanced stages beyond the Nishtha stage. So, but we can know about them and get inspired, and we can aspire for these stages in future. Yeah. And we can also do internal and external service. Internally, we can meditate mentally and following the activities of their Siddha Dehas, of pure devotees in their Swarupa. Externally, we can follow the activities of the Sadhaka form, how they chanted, ate, slept, preached, everything. And we should not become sahajayik. Therefore, we spoke last time about, we should not imitate the great pure personalities of spiritual world, like sahajyas. Some ISKCON devotee learned from some Radhakund Baba that he is a peacock in spiritual world. He started imitating a peacock foolishly. So, we said all these things last time. Or nobody should wear the dress of a sakhi externally, like a man wearing dress of a sari and pretending like a big gopi or something. It's foolishness. One should avoid these things, we said. But we should continue performing the activities of sadhana, namely, perform all the sadhana bhakti activities, vaidhi sadhana, and gradually become purified and increase the greed. Actually, when we come to the, today we will see also, in which stage, what hearing we should do, which will awaken that lobha. We will see that today. Yeah. So, Shravanam. Nama Shravana, Charita Shravana, Gunadi Shravana. Yeah. Like the snake bite is cured by a mantra. Similarly, the conditioned souls, laziness and fruit mentality will be finished by the chanting of the holy name. One should hear from moon-like devotees. Yeah. You can worship Tulasi and pray to her, express her Abhilasha to become a resident of Raja. Yeah. So after we finish this, so we finished all these things. So I left it to all of you to go through these things. Today we are proceeding to the next. These things last time I told you that you can go through it yourself. Okay. Now, we are continuing now, the second part of this purport. You can read now. Srila Rupa Goswami states in Bhakti Samchandu, Seva Sadhaka Rupena Siddha Rupena Chatrahi Tad Bhava Lipsana Karya Vraja Loka Anusarataha.
In the transcendental limbs of the Vraja, Vraja Dham, one should serve the Supreme Lord, Sri Krishna, with the feeling similar to that of his associates, and one should place himself under the direct guidance of a particular associate of the Krishna and should follow in his footsteps. This method is applicable both in the stage of the sadhana, spiritual practice executed while in the stage of the bondage, and in the stage of the sadhya, God realization. When one is in the siddha purusha or the spiritually perfect soul.
In the two stages, right now we have sadhana deha. Eventually, we will have Siddha Deha. In both the stages, the procedure is same. Two things we have to do. One is possess a feeling similar to Lord's associates. Now, are you feeling very strong Vatsalya for Krishna, like Yashoda? Or very strong conjugal attraction to Krishna, like Radharani and Gopis? Or one is feeling a very strong friendly mood, like Sridhama, Sudhama, Madhumangal? Or very strongly feeling a servitorship mood after Ratak, Patrak, Chitrak? One of these four moods is very attractive to you, then one should possess that feeling in one's heart. And also one should place oneself under the direct guidance of a particular associate of Krishna, like these associates I told you. But they are actually too far away for us. Therefore, we go to them through the spiritual master. So, in one of the classes before, probably I narrated the pastime of Srinivas Acharya. Did I? In a nectar of instruction. But maybe I will tell you briefly, so that will give you a clue about this. One Srinivas Acharya in Bengal, sitting in his home, he went into rapt meditation for hours together. And the family members could not bring him out. They sprinkled water. He was not coming out. They became worried. Practically all day he was in meditation. Then they were meditating, let Ramachandra Kaviraj, who is his very dear disciple, come here and he will help us. But then he is very far away. It will take 2 months to go to bring him. But then as soon as they thought of him, he came. So he sat next to Srinivas Acharya, his guru, and told all the people, "Don't worry, Vaishnavas. I will meditate and find out where my guru has gone." And then he also meditated and went into meditation very deeply. And people were worried that, oh, both have gone into meditation. Now, where are they? Are they alive? Are they dead? Everybody was very worried. In the meantime, what happened? Srinivas Acharya is a disciple of Gopalapati Goswami. And Ramachandra Kaviraj is a disciple of Srinivas Acharya. So, it's a disciplic line. Gopalapati Goswami, Srinivas Acharya, Ramachandra Kaviraj. And all the three had their Siddha Deha in the spiritual world. Their forms were, Gopalapati Goswami's name was Gunamanjari. You can remember GG. Gopalapati Goswami's Gunamanjari in the spiritual world. And Srinivas Acharya is Mani Manjari. Srinivas Acharya. And Ramachandra Kaviraj is Karuna Manjari. So there are three of them. That means Gunamanjari, Mani Manjari, Karuna Manjari. Three Manjaris in the spiritual world. So, when Gunamanjari, which means Srinivas Acharya, not Gunamanjari, Mani Manjari, which is Srinivas Acharya, Ramachandra Kaviraj. Now, in this pastime, our Gopalapati Goswami doesn't come into picture in the Sadhana Deha. Only two are there here. Who? Srinivas Acharya and Ramachandra Kaviraj. They are sitting next to each other. So, when Ramachandra Kaviraj, who is Karuna Manjari, went to spiritual world, he saw in the bank of Yamuna, all the gopis had assembled and many gopis were entering into waters to search for something. So, he saw his guru there. Srinivas Acharya was in his Siddha Deha. What is the form? His name was Mani Manjari. So, Karuna Manjari saw Mani Manjari. So, he went to Mani Manjari and asked, "What are you searching, my Gurudev?" She said, "Radharani's ankle bells, Nupur, has got lost because yesterday night Sri Devi, Sri Ji and Krishna and gopis were dancing here. When she danced, her Nupur fell into the waters. So, we are all searching." "You also search," she said. So, therefore, he also got engaged in Seva. So therefore, both of them were missing. They had left the body and gone like that. Now they left the Sadhana Deha, went to Siddha Deha. So while searching, fortunately Karuna Manjari got it. And she thought, "How can I directly give it to Radharani?" So he gave it to his guru, Mani Manjari. Mani Manjari gave it to Guna Manjari. And Guna Manjari gave it to Shrimati Radharani. So when Radharani got it, she became so pleased. She asked who got it and everything. And then she called Mani Manjari and then blessed Mani Manjari also. And then she gave her tambulam, which she, from her own mouth, she gave the tambul, very fragrant one. Radharani gave it as a gift. So Mani Manjari accepted, but then Mani Manjari didn't keep it herself, because she thought that who originally gave the ankle? Well, Karuna Manjari. So he gave to Karuna Manjari. And Karuna Manjari very gratefully accepted it. So then this pastime was over in the spiritual world. Radharani's Nupur is back. They all got it. So now, everybody was greatly surprised, because Karuna Manjari returned back with a loud Harivo like that. Then within next few minutes, Srinivas Acharya, he also came back, Harivo. And then after that, there was a big festival celebrated by all Vaishnavas, seeing these two Vaishnavas back to life. Hariharaye Namah, Krishna Yadavaya Namaha, Yadavaya Madhavaya Keshavaya Namaha, Gopal Govindaram Shri Madhusudan, గిరిధారి గోపినాథ్ మదన మోహన్ శ్రీ చైతన్య నిత్యానంద శ్రీ అద్వైత సీత హరి గురు వైష్ణవ భాగవత గీత హరి గురు వైష్ణవ భాగవ శ్రీ రూప సనాతన భట్ట రఘునాథ్ శ్రీ జీవ గోపాల భట్ట దాస రఘునాథ్ హరే కృష్ణ హరే కృష్ణ 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 హరే 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 రామ 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 హరే హరే కృష్ణ హరే కృష్ణ 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 హరే 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 రామ హరే కృష్ణ 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 హరే 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 రామ 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 హరే హరే నిత్య గౌరంగ జయ నిత్య గౌరంగ నిత్య గౌరంగ జయ నిత్య గౌరంగ హరి బోల్ హరి బోల్ హరి బోల్ నిత్య గౌర హరి బోల్ So, all Vaishnavas sang and danced with great jubilation. But suddenly everybody felt a great fragrance. Where is this coming from? Where is it coming from? Everybody was asking one another. At that time, Karuna Manjari from the Dhoti, he released that Tambulam given by Srimati Radharani. Although she gave it to these personalities in the spiritual world, in their Siddha Deha, now that Tambulam came into the Sadhana Deha clothes now. So Sadhana Deha is this body, what we all have right now, with which we are doing Sadhana. It's called Sadhana Deha. But from Siddha Deha, Manjari Deha, they got Tambulam here. And then everybody was given to smell it. And they told the whole pastime what happened in spiritual world. In this way, even we all have a Sadhana Deha right now, but we have Siddha Deha also. We do not know that, what it is. Eventually, it will be revealed to us. The 12 details will be revealed. Who are you in the spiritual world? What is your name? In whose group are you serving? Who is your team leader in your group? What all sevas are allotted to you? What type of dress you wear? Which is the spot in which you have to go for entering service? In what rasa you will exchange love with Krishna and other devotees? You see, all this is mentioned. It will all be revealed to us as we keep on chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, and staying in the custody of Guru, guidance of Guru, and adopting the mood over a period of time. Right now, we only have to adopt only one mood, that I am servant of Krishna. And actually, we have to increase our longing to attain Krishna's lotus feet in the mood of a servant now. Later on, further moods of friendship and Vatsalya and Madhuri will be revealed as we advance. How to serve like pure devotees? Yeah.
We are right now Vaidhi Sadhaka Bhaktas. First of the four stages, Vaidhi Raganuga Bhavan Prema. In all the four stages, we need a pure devotee's shelter. Even at the Prema stage, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to Ishwarpuri to check why he showing the symptoms of the ecstasy.
Kiba Mantra Dila Gosai Kiba Tarabal. Japite, japite, hoila pagal. He said, Guruji, what mantra have you given? I have been chanting as per your order, but now I am going spiritually mad. Tears are springing from my eyes and hair is standing on end, body is trembling. You know, I am wondering what is this, what are the symptoms? And Guru patted on the back and said, well done, my Guru disciple. These are the symptoms of loving ecstasy. It's very nice that you are manifesting these symptoms. Go on with your chanting Hare Krishna, he said. So in this way, even in Prema Bhakti stage, Gauranga Mahaprabhu is seeking guidance and shelter of Guru, which shows that the devotee should never think, now I have become advanced devotee, I don't need any guidance, such foolishness. Next one, disciple.
Disciple should consult Guru even in the Prema stage. We will continue to serve Guru even in the Prema stage. We will serve Radharani under Guru's guidance.
Actually, we don't know Radharani. We can't serve her directly. So under the guidance of Guru, we will try to adopt the proper seva bhav, service attitude, and then serve Srimati Radharani. And then eventually Radharani's mercy will come to us through the Guru's guidance. Bhaktivinoda Saraswati Thakur says,
one who has not yet developed the interest in Krishna consciousness should give up all material motives and train his mind by following the progressive regulative principle, namely chanting and the remembering Krishna and his name, form, quality, pastime and so forth. In this way, after developing a taste for the such thing, one should try to live in the Vrindavan and pass his time constantly remembering Krishna's name, fame, pastime and qualities under the direction and the protection of an expert devotee.
Yeah, see, there are two stages, Bhaktivinoda Thakur says. One is the stage when we have not yet developed a great taste for chanting more and more rounds. We have not yet developed such a taste, strong taste. But we have some implicit faith that devotees are good and Krishna consciousness is good. I will take shelter of a guru and I will come to ISKCON and I will get initiated. Okay. We have not developed a strong taste, but we do it under the guidance of a guru. Then at that stage, what you should do? Two things, he says. One is give up all material motives. Anya bilashita shunya. Secondly, he says, train the mind by following the progressive regulative principles like shravanam, kirtanam, smananam of nam rupa guna lila. Two things we have to do. Give up the material motivation, anya bilashita shunya. And at the same time, along with that, anukulyana Krishna anushilanam. Keep engaging in Krishna's service, hearing name, form, qualities, pastimes. And after the strong taste is developed, very strong taste has developed now, I want to constantly chant Krishna's names, I want to, one is feeling great love for Krishna. Then what one should do? Then one should go to Vrindavan Dham. Or make one's place like Vrindavan. And pass one's time in further hearing about Krishna's name, fame, qualities, pastimes and everything, like that he says. Under the protection of an expert devotee in advanced stages. Yeah.
Who is associate of the Krishna? Associate of the Krishna means the spiritual master. If you become very advanced, then spiritual master may give you certain meditations. These are given at the Raganuga stage.
So, Srila Prabhupada himself is a Vajabasi who was in Vrindavan. And he left Vrindavan and went to America to preach. So we are under the guidance of Srila Prabhupada. We are under the guidance of Panchatattva, Shishi Gaur Nitayan. So we don't have to go to any Radhakunda Babaji or any extraneous thing we don't have to do to attain this devotion. Therefore, we should stay under the guidance of our own spiritual master who is in the shelter of Prabhupada. From here, I am going to tell you the further advanced stages, how we will develop from Smaranam. Yeah. Yeah, mind's nature is?
Mind's. To identify with and to influenced by the qualities of the things on which it dwells.
Nature of our mind is, you are where your mind is, it is said. That means, if you put our mind in spiritual items, then mind gets absorbed in it. If you put your mind in material items, then mind gets absorbed in it. But the difference is what? If you put your mind in spiritual items, by spiritual absorption, mind gradually becomes liberated. It attains freedom. Becomes purer and purer and free and free. And if you put your mind in material items, the mind gets entangled in rajaguna, tamaguna. And mind gives you enormous sufferings because of contact with matter and material contamination. So therefore, one should make the choice of withdrawing the mind from the clutter of matter, material absorption, and put it in spiritual absorption.
To chase after sense object and suffer.
Mind's nature is to run after the sense objects. And then when he comes across sense objects, he suffers. Like sometimes there is a chase of the mind after eating. He eats a lot of food and then he suffers. He suffers from indigestion. Same way with all other objects.
To focus on the Supreme Lord in the pure stage, become absorbed in Krishna consciousness.
When the mind becomes purified, then it becomes completely focused on Supreme Lord. That is the beauty. See, these are all different natures of the mind. See, what does the first picture show? No, there is greedy. Extremely greedy. And second fellow? He is splitting his hair. Which means it's very, very much in anxiety or stress. And third picture shows envy. And the fourth picture below shows depressed. He's depressed. And next picture shows confused and indecisive. And next picture shows somebody is very jolly now, at the current moment. He may not be jolly all the time, but at least now he is jolly. So like this, mind always undergoes ups and downs with these emotions. Like, you know, somebody is wondering why different people deal with me in different ways. One becomes moody with the mind. Like, why this fellow is ridiculing me? So that fellow is wondering. Or why this fellow is showing all his teeth, yelling at me? We are all always disturbed in the mind. So therefore, if you want to advance in spiritual life, you have to give prolonged exposure, spiritual exposure to the mind to really create some spiritual impressions. So this is a way to create impression. Because we are looking towards the material world with the enjoying mentality, repeated interaction with the material world increases material absorption. Similarly, we have to increase repeated interaction with spiritual items. Then you get spiritual impressions.
Practicing remembrance of Sri Krishna. First, primarily qualification. Second, an austere way of life. Third, proper cultivation.
I found this very helpful. This is Shivaram Swami Maharaj in his Shuddha Bhakti Chintamani. He says this based on Prabhupada books. He says very simple three procedures. If you adopt this very simple three procedures, you know, very soon we can relieve ourselves from material absorption completely and awaken spiritual absorption towards Krishna.
Always engage in hearing Krishna Katha. This is called the Shravan Dasha.
This is explained in the purport of Prabhupada and Nectar of Instruction. When one is given an imperative statement, always engage in hear Krishna Katha. One may not want to hear at this stage, but one is told, one must hear.
By constantly hearing holy name and the fame, Krishna's Katha, it's called Varna Dasha. In this stage, he becomes attached to Krishna Katha.
Yeah. First, if you engage in hearing Krishna Katha, attraction comes. And you continue hearing Krishna Katha, attachment comes. Varana Dasha.
When one is able to chant in the ecstasy, it's called Smaran Avastha.
Yeah. So, this is a very important slide because this is directly from the purport of Prabhupada. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur explains these things. All of us are hearing Krishna Katha, isn't it? We are hearing Bhagavatam class, Bhagavad Gita class, Bhakti Shastri classes and everything. But here he says, we should come to a stage where we will always engage in hearing Krishna Katha. Which means, not only we study for Bhakti Shastri, or not only we fill up the sadhana card that some 3 hours per week or 4 hours per week I have studied, you know. That type of little study will not do. One should always engage in hearing Krishna Katha. That means one should be very, very fond of hearing in the morning, hearing in the afternoon, hearing in the evening. One should delight in hearing about Krishna. So when that kind of attraction for hearing, actually initial attraction may not be there. We may hear it. But over a period of time, after hearing the amazing name, form, qualities, pastimes of Krishna, the kind of eagerness increases, utsaha, which was seen in Parikshit Maharaj. Sukadeva Goswami says that Parikshit, yan notanayasi ishasya, shrinvanapi katamuhuhu. He says that for you, Krishna Katha appears ever fresh and new. You never get tired, you never get bored. You want to hear more and more, he says. So, not only Parikshit was willing to just silently listen, he was also inquiring. Very intelligent inquiries he makes. You said that the coward boys went back and told the parents about Agasur Leela 1 year later. Why 1 year later? What happened in that 1 year? Then Sukadeva Goswami appreciates him and goes on with Brahma Vimohan Leela, which happened in that 1 year period. So Similarly, Sukadeva Goswami sometimes would wrap up a pastime very fast. So he said, there was one very big Kaliya Nag, which came to Vrindavan and took shelter of Yamuna, and then Krishna danced on the hood of the Kaliya and drove him out of Vrindavan. That's all. In one shloka, he finished the whole pastime. But Parikshit Maharaj put a sudden break and said, my dear sir, please tell me, who is that Kaliya? Where did he come from? What was his intention in coming and taking shelter of Yamuna? How did Krishna subdue that snake? So please tell me everything more elaborately, he said. Do not think that I have not drunk water or I have not eaten food for 7 days, 7 nights. In fact, your Krishna Katha is giving me food, he said. I am getting nourishment. So in this way, as we keep hearing more and more, the strong taste for hearing Krishna Katha will increase. It's called Shravana Dasha, we call it. And if you constantly hear either the holy name or holy fame, holy fame is Srimad Bhagavatam, holy name is Hare Krishna Mantra. When we come to a stage where we cannot stop sharing Krishna's glories, even for one moment also, then we come to the Varana Dasha. In this stage, one becomes attached to Krishna Katha. One is unable to stop even for one moment also. Continuously one wants to hear, moment after moment. And then, after hearing in this way, two ways, Shravana Dasha and Varana Dasha, hearing, then one wants to share it with others. When one is able to chant in ecstasy, then one goes to Smarana Avastha. So we should be able to chant in with ecstatic love, whatever we heard in Guru Parampara. So in this way, the Shravan leads to Varan, leads to Smaran. That's the way. Now, that was the first one. Preliminary qualification means basically hearing. That's all. Shanvata shraddaya nityam granatascha sajeshtitam kalena nati dirgena bhagavan vishate hridi. It says, Lord Hari enters the heart of that fellow who sincerely hears. With great transcendental faith, he hears. So that's the preliminary qualification, nothing else. The Shravanam. Second is an austere way of life,
Live in a way conducive to the controlling the mind. Second, avoid things that will be again agitates the mind with the sensual thoughts. Third, this is what is the means by the living an austere life.
Living an austere life doesn't mean you go to Himalayas or anything like that. It's simple Vaishnava ways by which you can control the mind, and mind will not again run back to material objects. See, I will show you in the next slide what is that austerity. This is it. In Bhagavad Gita, it's mentioned austerity of mind. Mana prasada samyatmam maunam matmamini graha pava samshuddhiritya tapomana samuchyate. Translation.
And satisfaction, simplicity, gravity, self-control, and the purification of one's existence are the austerities of the mind.
We have to cultivate these things. If you want to do Shravanam very nicely, effectively, we can also follow this austerity of the mind. By gravity and self-control, we can avoid utilizing the tongue for criticizing others and implicating ourselves. See, highlighted portion. To make the mind austere is to
detach it from the sense gratification.
It should also be trained.
It
should be trained that it can always.
Always thinks of the doing good for others. The best training for the mind is the gravity in the thought.
So each of these items Prabhupada explains, but the main thing he will say here is detach from sense gratification, detach from sense gratification repeatedly. That's the main teaching here.
Nothing is possible without the tapasya. Lord Brahma, however, was empowered to create this entire universe because of his austerity. The more we engage in the austerities, the more we become the powerful by the grace of the Lord. Therefore, Rishabhadev advised his sons, Tapo Divyam Putraka Enat Satvam Shuddhe. One should engage in the penance and the austerity to attain the divine position of the devotional service. By such activities, one's heart is purified. In our material existence, we are impure and therefore we cannot do anything wonderful. But if we purify our existence by the tapasya, we can do wonderful things by the grace of the Lord.
Amazing, no? తపో దివ్యం నో పెయిన్స్ నో గెయిన్స్. సో ప్రభుపాద్ సేస్ ఇన్ దట్ నూనం దిస్ దట్ ఇస్ ఇన్ వర్స్ యు నో ఫస్ట్ వర్స్ స్పోకన్ బై రిషభదేవ్ టు హిస్ 100 సన్స్ దట్ ఇస్ మై డియర్ సన్స్ యు నో వన్ షుడ్ నాట్ యూటిలైజ్ ద హ్యూమన్ బాడీ ఫర్ లివింగ్ లైక్ అ పిగ్ హి సేస్ స్టూల్ ఈటర్స్ ఫర్ సెన్స్ గ్రాటిఫికేషన్ వెన్ అ మ్యాన్ యూజెస్ హిస్ బాడీ ఫర్ సెన్స్ గ్రాటిఫికేషన్ దెన్ హిస్ బాడీ బికమ్స్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ లైక్ దట్ ఆఫ్ అ పిగ్ హి సేస్ Then somebody may ask them, what do we do? Then you have to do tapasya. Well, you know, trees are doing tapasya. They are tolerated in the heat of the summer, cold of the winter, isn't it? So then what type of tapasya we should do? That is not tapasya here he is talking. Tapo divyam. Tapasya in relation to Lord Krishna. Tapasya for the pleasure of Lord Krishna. Such tapasya should be performed. And that will actually detach us from unwanted situations in this world. And that can actually give us, you know, Brahma Saukhyam, the boundless spiritual happiness which comes by the Tapo Divyam. Divya means divine. Tapo Divya means divine austerity.
Srila Prabhupada once advised a disciple, simply our prayer should be, My dear Krishna, please remind me to always chant your holy name. Please do not put me into the forgetfulness. You are sitting within me. As the super soul, so you can put me into the forgetfulness or into the remembering you. So please do not put me into the forgetfulness. Please always remind me to chant. Even you send me to hell, it doesn't matter. Just so long as I can always chanting Hare Krishna.
This is the way devotee should pray. Devotee should be ready to go anywhere, but should beg Krishna, please. Even if you have to become a worm in the house of a devotee, no problem. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, I simply want to be your devotee. So in this way we should call out the holy name in a prayerful mood. That's a secret.
How to increase our spiritual mental absorption by proper cultivation of habits?
In the beginning, people come for a 6-session course. And after that they think that's all, that's spiritual life. And they go away, many people. But some people after that keep coming for a weekly program. And some people chant one or two rounds for years together. Or some people come to 16 rounds and become serious devotees. They get initiated also. Then they undergo Bhakti Shastra training also. After that what? After that, therefore it is mentioned here, Shravana Dasha, Varana Dasha, Smarana Avastha, those stages we showed you. Shravana Dasha means one should actually hear more and more and more. And that attraction should develop. By such hearing. How do you know attraction will develop? Like you see, when Srila Prabhupada was sitting in Koshi, there was a Sheshasayi temple. Announcement was made. Those devotees who wish to go for darshan of Sheshasayi temple could go. Others who want to hear from Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur can stay back. And our Abhay Babu, Prabhupada, he stayed back because there was attraction to hearing from the Guru. So, do we look forward to hearing or we hear because we are supposed to. That's how you can know whether you are attraction or not. Because we always have so many other busy things to do. Many people don't hear regularly and the shravanam becomes very poor. And it's like watering the devotional creeper. If you don't water it, it will not grow. So regular hearing is very important. So after the attraction comes, when we continue hearing, next stage comes, Varana Dasha, where one's attachment hearing comes. Attachment is more greater than attraction. Attachment, one becomes really spiritually mad. One repeatedly, like Mahaprabhu used to say, speak it again, Dhruva Maharaj's story, Prahlad Maharaj's story, speak it again, he would say. So that type of mad attraction comes. That is Varana Dasha. And then Smaranavastha means a person's mind becomes completely absorbed. So that's what we are going to talk about now, how to increase our spiritual mental absorption. Actually, when the chitta becomes absorbed in Shuddha Krishna Shiksha, at that time, mind switches off to the material world outside. It will not get any interference from any material stimuli. So there are some cultivation of habits we can do.
By following the 64 regularity principle,
యత్ అనుజ్ఞాసినా యుక్త కర్మ గ్రంథి నిబంధనం చిందంతి కోవిదాస్తస్య కోన కుర్యాత్ కథారతిం Who in this world will not have katharathi, attraction to hearing the katha of the Lord, because the katha of the Lord can act as a powerful sword in cutting the knot of material bondage, like that this verse says. Therefore, with great enthusiasm and attention, hear Krishna katha, like that that verse says. Matchitta madgata prana bodhayanta parasparam kathayantascha mam nityam tushyanti cha ramanti cha. He is saying bodhayanta means people like to sit and hear from other Vaishnavas. Kathayantascha means they like to speak to other Vaishnavas also. And with their minds and hearts they like to meditate on Krishna, matchitta. So with their mind and heart they meditate on Krishna. With their ears they hear from other Vaishnavas, bodhayanta. And then when they meet some devotees who are younger to them, then they may also speak to them. In this way, these are the ways to cultivate good habits, to cultivate for spiritual mental absorption. Yeah.
Developing the Shastra Chakshu, to see the world.
That means see the world from the viewpoint that Shastras explain us properly. Yeah.
Memorizing the Vaishnava songs and the shlokas.
Yeah. So, like when you see the sun and moon and material world, you should see this is Krishna's material energy. Binnamya prakritrashtada. And when you see the rains coming, you know, plants growing, you should think maya adhyakshena prakriti. Like that one should see. That is Shastra Chakshu. And memorizing Vaishnava songs, because Vaishnava songs are all very purely written by acharyas, keeping in line the mood of Shastra. So, and they are also writing in a very humble mood and tolerant mood. So, it will be very helpful for us to cultivate Vaishnava qualities by reading Vaishnava songs.
Praying by begging for service, repentance and the shelter.
Repentance for our past sins, shelter at the lotus feet of Radha and Krishna, and begging for seva opportunity.
Empties mind of all other thoughts.
If you are always in a prayerful mood, that makes mind completely empty of unwanted thoughts. Yeah.
Help to gain the mastery over mind. Ability to think of the Krishna at will.
These are the advantages of prayer. Vandanam. So, let us learn to pray. Like Lord Chaitanya is praying in Shikshashtakam. So, like that we also need to know how to offer personal prayers to Lord also. So, these are various ways for cultivating habits. There are more habits also. Yeah.
Accepting service from the Vaishnava superior and do services with the prayerful seva bhav. Think of the Sri Krishna directly and indirectly.
Directly means name, form, qualities, pastimes, activities, Krishna Leela. And indirectly means studying about Kala, Karma, Gunas, such kinds of things.
Directly, Nama, Rupa, Guna, Leela, gold weight. Depends on the spontaneous attachment. Indirectly, Krishna's Shakti, iron weight, depends on the intellectual effort.
So, initially we cultivate indirect knowledge about Krishna, namely Ishvara, Jiva, Prakriti, Kala, Karma from Bhagavad Gita. It's like iron weight. After we know that the gunas are acting powerfully, karma is acting powerfully, Kala is acting powerfully, so then we understand the seriousness of our predicament. Then we become interested in the person Krishna. Then we hear his name, form, qualities. That's called gold weight. We begin with iron weight and then go to gold weight.
When a living entity comes in contact with the material creation, his service attitude is transferred into the propensity for the sense enjoyment.
Yeah. So, you all know how Bharat Maharaj fell prey to attachment to a deer, and the next life he became a deer due to all these things. This is moha. So one should study these pastimes very attentively, carefully, that how he gradually degraded in his mental absorption due to the shoka and moha and bhaya. He completely lost track of his spiritual life because of gradual distraction. So, we don't want to be distracted like this. Therefore, we want to develop a permanent greed for Krishna consciousness, which will elevate us in these 9 stages. So, let us see how do we do that. See, the human beings are divided into two categories, non-regulated, regulated. Non-regulated are almost like animals only. In that there are two, civilized animals and uncivilized, educated and strong people, uncivilized, uneducated and weak people. So some people are atheistic people, even though they are superficially dressed well and they shake hands, they're educated. They may be strong financially or they may be strong, you know, in their material achievements and all. But still, nevertheless, they are non-regulated category. They have nothing to give and take with God. And uncivilized, uneducated, weak people are needless to talk about. These people have no faith in God, nor are they interested to learn about God. So, although they are humans, we have to keep them in another category. And let's go to the regulated.
Following the scripture for the material enjoyment, those working for the liberation, devotees in Krishna consciousness.
Yeah. Those are working for liberation. Like jnanis, yogis, bhaktas. They are considered as regulated because they actually study the Shastra, they follow the Shastra and follow some path to either attain impersonal liberation or go back to Godhead.
In human form of the life, we have got developed intelligence to discriminate and lead responsible lives.
Yeah. Only in human life you can think about, who am I? Why did I take birth in this world? Why am I suffering? What's the goal of life? What is in my hand now? What can I do now to make my life perfect?
If we engage in the sinful activity, we degrade to lower life forms. If we lead responsible life following the religious principle and the practicing austerity, sacrifice, cultivation of the knowledge, association with the saintly persons.
Like these are the activities. You know the famous song, Bajogare Manasa. So these spiritual activities if we engage in. Shravana Kirtana Smarana Mandana Pasedana. So I have taken from the song.
The man who has escaped these three gates of the hell, lust, anger and the greed, O son of Kunti, perform act conducive to the self-realization and thus gradually attain the supreme destination. We elevate gradually to the kingdom of the God.
By all these steps, study of Veda, austerity, sense control, spiritual knowledge, accepting Guru in the beginning. So, here Prabhupada says there are three types of people while practicing spiritually amongst us. Let us see we fall in which category. First is unsuccessful yogi who fails. Like here you see Sobarimani fell away, married 50 daughters of Mandata king. And here is Vishwamitra becoming fascinated by Menaka. He gave up his penance and went with her, begot Shakuntala and all that. So in this way, some people have material desires. Either on earthly plane they satisfy it, or they go to heaven, satisfy it and they come to the earth. And then they are born in the family of Shuchinam Shimata Gehe, in the Brahmana family or aristocratic family. Like here you see, in the Brahmana family, a small boy learns from the father to be prayerful, and they eat nice, beautiful prasadam. And they study scriptures, lead a very pure and simple life. Or aristocratic family, there is no dearth of money for them. Everything is available for them. So in this way, Krishna says for his devotee, even if you have material desires, there is no loss. You go to heaven, fulfill the material desires, come to earth, born in a Brahmana aristocratic family. This is one category. Second category, but if a yogi is unsuccessful because 90% he has finished, but after that he couldn't continue because he left the body. The next life is born in the family of Vaishnava Acharya, Vaishnava devotees, where he continues, Abhay, small boy. So his father, Gaurmande, was a devotee. He supported his activities very nicely. Like that he says. So this second category. Then one more category is going to say now, third one. This is called as the forlorn category of a devotee. Read the heading.
the red color.
Those who
are the causal become
casualty.
Casualty to conscious of the Krishna.
No, and those who are casual become casualty. Therefore, be Krishna, be conscious of Krishna and cautious of Maya. So Bharat was conscious of Krishna, but careless about Maya. Whereas Jadabharata was conscious of Krishna also and cautious of Maya also. Therefore, he was like a dumb man or a deaf man, blind man. He wouldn't talk to anybody. So Jadabharata was like that. So Jadabharata was cautious of Maya and Bharat was conscious of Krishna. Which one is important? Both are important. You see, the first category I told you, Shuchinam Shimatam Gehe category. They go to heaven, come back and be born in a Brahmana family or aristocratic family. They are basically pious people having done little bit of Krishna consciousness. The second category is more advanced category. 90% of Krishna consciousness they have done. They are born in an Acharya family like Prabhupada, Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, like that. And the third category is another very special category, where a person is put in a forlorn condition. Forlorn condition means like Indradumna Raja became Gajendra and caught by a crocodile. He was put in a forlorn condition. Bharat Maharaj became distracted and became a deer in the next life, put in a forlorn condition. Prabhupada says this forlorn condition devotees are most fortunate, he says, because they have nowhere to go. They cry and go running to Krishna's shelter. Like that. Like as a Bharat Maharaj is a deer, many symptoms you will see, he didn't degrade, rather his devotion service got accelerated. You know, he left the birthplace of Kalanjara Mountains and went to Palahashrama to keep away from the family and relatives, not to get entangled. Similarly, he ate dry grass instead of green grass. He also listened to the lectures and sermons by saintly people. He constantly, repeatedly lamented how careless I was. Now I will be more attentive and careful. In this way, the alertness of the devotee increases when he is put in a forlorn condition. So, I will not read these things. You can read it yourself. Same thing what I told you till now is there here. So I can read the yellow one, highlight it.
Now, out of the three, either he gets his birth in a Brahmana family or in a rich family or in the family where the people are the members are the highly advanced in the yoga. So Krishna says in the third one is to be considered the more fortunate. Third one who has got his birth in the family of the yogi, because one who has got his birth in a rich family, he may be misled. And naturally, it is so happened when a man gets riches, silver spoon in the mouth, he thinks, "Oh, I have got so much money. My paternal property.
Let me enjoy it." Yeah.
Oh, so something he becomes a drunk.
Sometimes he becomes a drunkard, a prostitute hunter. I mean to say a rogue because of the money. Sometimes the Brahmana boy like Ajamila got misled. Sometimes a rich person like our Nalakur Manigriva got misled, like that Prabhupada said. So yellow one, yeah.
So in the pious family or in the rich family, there is a chance of the degradation. But one who takes his birth in the family of the yogi, devotee, he has got a better chance for the cultivating the same spiritual culture from which in his past life he had fallen. Therefore, Krishna says,
This is very rare.
That a man gets his birth, a parents, a yogi, this is very rare. In his previous birth, in his previous body, whatever he cultured, now he begins to remember. I may tell you that those who had taken this society, Krishna consciousness, very seriously, they are not ordinary person. They must have such a culture in their previous life. Now, they are again trying to revive that things.
So, now, I am bringing this point. Why I will tell you. It is not enough to just chant 16 rounds and follow 4 regs and then wait for the Vaikuntha airplane to come and take us back to Godhead throughout our life. Although Prabhupada says that if you chant 16 rounds and follow 4 regs, you know, you will go back to Godhead. Actually, if you go back to Godhead, what will you do there after going? After going there, if you have to lovingly serve Krishna, we have to develop greed while being in this world. Right now, what is our situation? Think about it. You know, we do our 16 rounds in the morning. Once the 16 rounds are over, we keep the bead bag aside. Done for today. Liberated from the bead bag till tomorrow morning. And the daytime, we have our most enthusiastic, busy activities to do. I have this service, I have that service. So many other pleasurable seva engagements which we do. But our heart is not yet, you know, eager for calling out the holy name very sincerely, or hearing the Krishna Katha very sincerely. There are many people who come for yatras. There are many people who like prasadam. There are many devotees who like kirtan, melas. But there are few people who are willing to steadily every day read and hear Krishna Katha, which is very, very essential actually. And there are very few who will chant beyond 16 rounds. And there are very few who will take up menial services or background services, like not very prominently noticeable in the front. So, therefore, one should know that the state of heart has to have one lobha. Krishna bhakti rasa bhavitamati kriyatam api kuto vilabhyate tatra laulyam api ekala mulyam janma koti sukritir na labhyate. This verse is by Vishnu Chaitanya Thakur, says this. Prabhupada got the word for the ISKCON movement from here only. Rasa bhavitamati means one's mind completely absorbed like a sponge in water, absorbed in Krishna rasa. Krishna bhakti rasa bhavita mati kriyatam api kuto vilabhyate. So if somebody has a mati which is very, very absorbed in Krishna always, he is thinking of Krishna, speaking about Krishna, relishing Krishna consciousness, one has to associate with the person and borrow it, he is saying. No matter how costly it is, you have to borrow it, he says. So only from a lover of Krishna you will get love. Only from a lusty rogue you will get lust. Like you will see Ajamila. He saw a lusty rogue in the forest, and by association of Ajamila with that fellow for a momentary period of time, he got lost, isn't it? I mean, on the other hand, Narada boy, the Dasiputra, saw the lovers of Krishna, and the result was he also became a lover of Krishna, Narada, you see. So we have to associate with Bhagavad Sanghi, not with a Stri Sanghi. So that's the warning given. So especially if you are put in a forlorn condition, and then we meet the right devotee at that time, then we take shelter of the devotee very strongly. Now, therefore, we are talking about the lobha, intense greed.
Refer to the state where our soul and the overwhelming desire is to please Krishna in the particular way. As long as there is some other desire in our heart, the required intensity cannot manifest.
You need a certain type of intensity. It is not just casual service. Intensity means you love to serve. You are fond of serving. You are looking forward for service. You are begging for opportunity to serve. You are grateful for the service given to you. And the service is very absorbing for you. And the service enhances your remembrance of Krishna. And you long for the service again. And you want to do more and more of that service. So in this way, there is a very intense longing in the heart of a devotee, which is called lobha. Krishna tad bhakta karunya matra labhai kahetuka.
The mercy of the Krishna and his devotee is the only cause of lobha.
So when Krishna glances at us very mercifully, or his devotees bestow such lobha in us, then only we can get. Therefore, we have to find out who has that lobha in a big proportion. Especially great souls, sannyasis, gurus, you know, who have been in this movement for 30, 40, 50 years. Certainly, they carry a lot of lobha. Greed for loving and serving Krishna. By hearing from them, meeting them, we get a lot of strength also.
At what stage lobha appears? Usually, doesn't awake until the nishtha after anartha nivritti.
Only after nishtha we can expect. Like here you see, this is Shraddha. Number one is Shraddha. Two is Satsanga. Yeah, Bhajanakriya. And fourth is Anantana Vritti. Yeah, Nishta Asakti Ruchi. Correct, no? So, up to the stage of Anantana Vritti, we have to work very hard. Nishta onwards, the Lord will help very easily. He will make it very easy for us, like a downward slope. Okay, we have to cultivate these things, yeah.
Practice. Practice makes a man perfect.
Yeah, that's about Abhyas, which Krishna says. Similarly, detachment also. We have to become detached from all that is not at all favorable for Krishna consciousness. You will easily understand if you go through this.
Following the Vraja basis in the
Vraja basis
in the Raganuga stage, how devotees know which Vrajavasi to follow? First, devotees who are qualified to cultivate such a relationship would not ask his question.
You would not ask this question, which means if you are asking, Prabhu, should I follow Yashoda or should I follow Radharani? Should I follow Sridhama? That means you have not yet reached the stage. Because those who have reached the stage will naturally know to whom their heart is drawn very much. And they will follow those Vrajavasis, yeah. The order of guidance of Guru. Yeah.
A natural and a special appreciation for the pastime of the Krishna. Third, awakes in the qualified devotee.
Awakens in the qualified devotees, yeah.
Fourth, as they hear Srimad Bhagavatam and chant Hare Krishna. Fifth, by continuously hearing and the chanting, a sincere devotee is always naturally drawn to a particular moods of the service and to a
mood of service
and to particular Vrajavasi.
One particular Vrajavasi personality and a particular mood of seva, like Yashoda and Vatsalya or Radharani gopis and one conjugal love or particular Vrajavasis like equal friends of Krishna or servants of Krishna. The whole idea is you are attracted to one personality and the mood in which they serve. So, here he is saying that you continue hear Bhagavatam and chant Hare Krishna. And over a period of time, all this will be revealed, yeah.
Things to be remembered. Srila Prabhupada and his
predecessors
have given the various methods such as praying for the remembrance, Srila Prabhupada, remembering the meaning of the mantra.
Mantra artha chintanam, Bhaktivinoda Thakur says.
Remembering the moods of the devotion and begging for the further qualification.
So these are things you can do. Like praying for remembrance, you can pray to Krishna, please. Krishna, you know, let me always remember you, let me not forget you. Let me fulfill your instructions. And while chanting Hare Krishna, remember the meaning of the mantra. Oh Hare, Ho Radharani, like that. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says. So,
qualification to enter the confidential pastimes through Srila Prabhupada books.
Yeah, from this I will take it in the next class, because from here we are going to talk about the variety type of devotees, different type of devotees, for neophyte devotees, advanced devotees, what they should hear, what they should read, and how they should strengthen their lobha. So we will talk it in the next class, and then we will also proceed to the ninth one next time. Vaikuntha Janito Varamudbhrita, short verse only, verse number 9. So we will complete this and go to verse 9, and we will finish that also next time. Shri Prabhupada ki, Gaur Bhaktavinoda ki.